Honorable Secretary Wong, dear Professor Shai, dear Professor Fong, Professor Yang, dear guests and dear online viewers. I have to say that it's a pleasure to be here today. It was not easy to organize because many organization issues were not easy with the current circumstances. But again, it's a great pleasure to be here in HKUEC, which is a wonderful campus. We just saw with Secretary Wong the solar panels. And this is really a reason to study again and to begin our studies in, if it would be possible. So thank you for your support. Today is a very special day. Today is a very special day because 5 years ago, for the first time in history, the world's nation came together in a single agreement to fight against climate change in an incredible and unique international momentum. And I remember it pretty well. I was in Paris at that time, and I have to say that everybody was stressed at the French MFA. Half of the French MFA was afraid of being fired in case of failure of the negotiation. And you can imagine that having 194 countries agree on a technical text is not easy. It's not easy. But we had this miracle. And so we had this text with the objective of limiting by the end of the century global warming to well below 2 Celsius degrees above pre-industrial levels and pursue efforts to limit it to 1.5 Celsius degree. So this is what Paris Agreement fixed. We have the spirit of this agreement, which is still alive. Today, it's not only a celebration. What we have to do is to all update our commitments, to enhance our commitments, to be sure to reduce our greenhouse gas emissions. And there is emergency. Emergency is still here, time is running out. 2020 is on the course to be the warmest year ever recorded, and I'm not saying that, it's the specialist, the World Meteorological Organization says that. We have more and more extreme meteorological events. We know them in France, we know them in France. We have stronger and stronger winds, hurricanes. In Hong Kong, I remember pretty well, I arrived in September 2018. And unfortunately, for my first weekend, I had the super typhoon Mangkhut. So it was not a very, very, it was a special welcoming. So I think this is really, really an issue for all. Today is a special day. Today is a special day. But I think that 2021 may be also a very, very special year. The recovery of the pandemic could be a chance and an opportunity for research to save our planet. This is only if we turn the post-pandemic recovery into an opportunity for a more resilient future, we may have again major diplomatic positive momentums ahead. For instance, today, France with the UK, with the UN, is co-hosting a virtual so-called ambition, climate ambition summit, which has as an objective to encourage countries to enhance their commitments before the COP26 in Glasgow. We will have other important momentums, such as the Kunming Conference on Biodiversity in May. And I have to say, to conclude, that the fight against climate change is more than ever a shared objective for the international community. And we have positive signals. Beijing announced that China will achieve carbon neutrality by 2060. President-elect Joe Biden's promise to have the US back into the Paris Agreement in early 2021. France and the EU are also taking their own responsibility. For the EU, I will say nothing. I will let the ambassador Thomas Gnocchi to give you a good news. But for France only, nearly a third of the government's 100 billion euro recovery plan to relaunch economy will be spent to speed up ecological transition. And for Hong Kong, I cannot speak for Hong Kong, but I have to say that Hong Kong is also joining forces with its latest announcement to achieve carbon neutrality by 2050. And this is, of course, a huge encouragement for all to work more in Hong Kong and with Hong Kong. I'm used to saying that climate change is not COVID-19. Closing borders is totally useless. Totally useless. So local cooperation can be very crucial to help to meet the challenge. All is about sharing good practices, and we have the chance in Hong Kong to have many French groups and French companies with huge expertise. I cannot quote everything, quote everybody, but in waste management we have Veolia, for instance, which built in the city one of the world's largest treatment facilities to turn sludge into electricity. We have companies such as Alstom, Transdev in the field of transportation, such as Bouygues or Schneider Electric, which are also bringing in new technologies. And we have also the major issue of green finance, and we will hear about it very soon. So I'm looking forward to listening to our panelists, and I'm sure that we will have many reasons at the end of this conference to be more optimistic for 2021. So thank you to everybody, and thank you also to all of our viewers online. Thank you.